today, testing the Vapor Street Elite. Check it out. Hi there, what's up guys, it's your Dawn Marathon. I'm breaking in the Vapor Street Elite. Not breaking feet, yeah, you heard it right. So let me add some few stats to the shoe, which I forgot yesterday in the video. The Vaporfly 4% has a 10 millimeter drop as all of Nike's racing shoes, but this one has 8 millimeter. Maybe this is even better for me, because it won't stress the Achilles that much as a 10 millimeter heel drop. So the other thing is, I'm in the shoes now for 8 kilometers. The carbon fiber plate, which is 1 millimeter thick and 24 grams, is inside the shoe without any glue. It's just tucked under my sole. And by now, it's feeling quite okay. I am not having any problems. And I think I can actually risk doing some intervals next time in these shoes. 6x1K interval. Or maybe even trying to post my 1 mile season best, which I've last week did in my Vaporfly 4%. A 5:33 mile. Maybe it's possible, but that will be the ultimate test whether these Vapor Street Elites are any good for training. So I'm trying to run a 5:33 mile in these. I know it's not a game because the plate is just 1 millimeter under my feet with all that big cushioning sandwich of 3 centimeters. But it's feeling good and it's bouncy. It's not as soft as the Vaporfly. The React foam is a little bit harder when you're walking. It's really going down like a mattress. But when you're running, it's really feeling good. That's what it's all about, feeling good. Feeling like Kipchoge. So I'm gonna leave you with one final dash and let you know as soon as I'm gonna do my intervals. And last but not least, the 1 mile time trial with a carbon fiber plate, which was in those Vaporfly 4%, which I ran the 5:33 mile with. So till then, stay tuned guys, your Dawn Marathon. Peace out.